Chapter 2 of the First Epistle of Peter, American Standard Version. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information and to find out how you can volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Recording by Sam Stinson, byhisfaith.com. Chapter 2. Putting away, therefore, all wickedness and all guile and hypocrisies and envies and all evil speakings, as newborn babes, long for the spiritual milk, which is without guile, that ye may grow thereby unto salvation, if ye have tasted that the Lord is gracious, unto whom coming a living stone, rejected indeed of men, but with God elect, precious. Ye also, as living stones, are built up a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices, acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Because it is contained in Scripture, Behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious. And he that believeth on him shall not be put to shame. For you, therefore, that believe, is the preciousness, but for such as disbelieve, the stone which the builders rejected, the same was made the head of the corner, and a stone of stumbling, and a rock of offense. For they stumble at the word, being disobedient, whereunto also they were appointed. But ye are an elect race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for God's own possession, that ye may show forth the excellencies of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, who in time past were no people, but now are the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Beloved, I beseech you as sojourners and pilgrims to abstain from fleshly lusts which war against the soul, having your behavior seemly among the Gentiles, that wherein they speak against you as evildoers, they may by your good works, which they behold, glorify God in the day of visitation. Be subject to every ordinance of man for the Lord's sake, whether to the king as supreme or unto governors as sent by him for vengeance on evildoers and for praise to them that do well. For so in the will of God that by well-doing ye should put to silence the ignorance of foolish men, as free and not using your freedom for a cloak of wickedness, but as bondservants of God. Honor all men, love the brotherhood, fear God, honor the king. Servants, be in subjection to your masters with all fear, not only to the good and gentle, but also to the froward. For this is acceptable, if for conscience toward God a man endureth griefs, suffering wrongfully. For what glory is it, if when ye sin and are buffeted for it, ye shall take it patiently? But if, when ye do well and suffer for it, ye shall take it patiently, this is acceptable with God. For hereunto were ye called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, that ye should follow his steps, who did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth, who, when he was reviled, reviled not again, when he suffered, threatened not, but committed himself to him that judgeth righteously, who his own self bare our sins in his body upon the tree, that we, having died unto sins, might live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. For ye were going astray like sheep, but are now returned unto the Shepherd and Bishop of your souls. End of chapter 2.